YouTube, Jessica here. Today I want to talk about how to quarantine your pet fancy goldfish. I have been keeping goldfish for just over a year, and I feel like I have learned 20 years worth of knowledge. I've definitely made 20 years worth of mistakes in my first year, but I have also come to the other side of that, and I feel like quarantining is something that I've really nailed down. Knock on wood, but I've really perfected my way of quarantining goldfish, and it has worked for me without loss since I started doing it this way. So I'd love to share what I'm doing and what's working for me. Although there are many ways to do things the right way, this is how I do it. So I'm going to be doing a water change on my quarantine tank. I have a goldfish from Goldfish Island that is in his 7th week of quarantining right now. And I'm going to go over the setup that he has been in and will continue to be in. And I will go ahead and do a water change demo for you. So stay tuned and thanks for watching. Okay, so here I am at the quarantine tank. Pebbles is in here. He's a crown pearl scale from Goldfish Island. So I'm gonna go over everything in detail that I have going on as his quarantine tank. First of all, the quarantine tank itself, it's just a Rubbermaid tote that I got at Walmart. It's 18 gallons and I think it cost me around $11. It came with a lid, which I don't use. And it's been great. It holds water. It doesn't bow after wear. It's been really great. So you can, of course, use a regular fish tank if you have an extra one. I just have all of my tanks in use right now, either as aquariums themselves or my fry tanks. So I am using this 11 or 18 gallon Rubbermaid tote as my quarantine tank for Pebbles here. So I also have a sponge filter that is rated for 40 gallons. So it's, you know, about double the filtration for this 18 gallon tote. It's just what I had on hand. In my other tank, my other quarantine tank right now, it's a 20 gallon and I'm using a sponge filter rated to 75 gallons. So the more the better, while, you know, not taking up the whole quarantine tank with filtration if you're using a sponge filter. I like using sponge filters because they cause the least amount of water disruption unless you are modifying a hang-on back filter to have slower flow. I just like a sponge filter. So I will go ahead and put in a link below. I'll put a link below for where you can purchase this on Amazon if your local fish store does not carry them. So the other thing, obviously, if you have a sponge filter, you would need an air pump. So here's the air pump that goes with a sponge filter. You just have the airline tubing and you plug the airline tubing into the air pump and the other side into the sponge filter. And I like the air pumps that have the adjustable dial on it so you can change the speed and intensity of the flow itself. If you don't have one of those, they have little flow regulating valves at PetSmart and Petco for like $2 that you can, you know, cut the airline and install that little flow regulator and then slow down the flow of the bubbles if you need to. So that, I mean, that's it. That's all I have going. So on to how I quarantine the actual goldfish and what I'm doing with my water changes and medication and stuff like that. First of all, I feel like the most important thing that I have to say about quarantining goldfish is I don't use cycled media from any of my existing tanks. All of my tanks right now, they're healthy tanks. There's no presence of disease or anything like that. And I know a lot of articles and people will say that you should use established media from a healthy aquarium to cycle the quarantine tank prior to the goldfish going into it. I just don't agree with that. And the main reason is because there's bacteria, obviously, in every single fish tank. That bacteria can turn into opportunistic bad bacteria at any sign of stress from the fish. It can be, same with parasites. I think fluke parasites are present in most bodies of water, and healthy fish are not typically susceptible to those parasites multiplying and actually causing harm to a healthy system. So in a stressed system, such as a quarantine tank though, you're talking about a fish coming from one body of water out of state, out of the country, and then going into, although healthy, bacteria from your established other goldfish tanks. The fish is under stress and it can fall victim to that opportunistic bacteria, causing harm or death to a fish that is stressed from shipping and handling. So I always let my fancy goldfish cycle their own quarantine tank. So I put a sponge that has not been used or has been sanitized and does not have any bacteria from an existing healthy aquarium in my home. And I just do daily water changes, or I test the water and decide when it's time for a water change. Pebbles has been in here for going on 7 weeks now. So his tank is cycled by now. I actually have not tested it because I just can tell by the clarity of the water when it needs a water change, or if the tank is in fact cycled and I can go a couple more days between water changes. But initially when I get the fish, I do daily or every other day in an 18 gallon tote as the example, I would do 100% water change every other day. So every 2 days I take Pebbles out and I dump this whole tote on my side yard and I refill it with aged water or water from my filtered hose. So that's kind of the main thing that I wanted to talk about in this video, is just that I don't cycle my, I don't pre-cycle my quarantine tanks before I get new goldfish. I let them kind of marinate in it with their own bacteria and let the whole thing just happen organically while making sure that the fish is not under any stress from ammonia or nitrite. So I just go ahead and do those regular water changes, and I don't introduce the new fish to bacteria from my other healthy tanks until about week 10 in quarantine. And that's when, I'll just go ahead and go into it. After the quarantine has made it to around 10 weeks, I quarantine for a total of 3 months, 12 weeks. Around 10 weeks, I will take a pitcher of water from Pebbles' quarantine tank, and I will dump it into the tank that Pebbles will be going into, which in my case is my 75 gallon with my other pearl scales. So I will take a pitcher of water from Pebbles' quarantine tank and put it in a 75 gallon, and I will also take a pitcher of water from the 75 gallon and dump it into the quarantine tank at every water change. So that gives the fish from both tanks a chance to get used to each other's different bacteria and microbes without the actual presence of one another, so that at the 3 month mark, when I put Pebbles into the tank with the other fish, they're not getting exposed to Pebbles' microbes and bacteria for the first time. They will have had a chance to acclimate to it and adjust to it for the 2 weeks prior to the actual introduction of the fish. So I have found that to be, that's been 100% successful for me doing it this way. A 3 month quarantine, letting the fish cycle its own tank while under the care and supervision of the parameters, and exchanging microbes 2 weeks prior to the actual introduction of the fish itself. That's the bulk of it. So next I'll go over what medications you can have on hand when you are quarantining your goldfish. So before I get into the medication, one of the topics I didn't cover yet is that I don't use a light on my quarantine tanks, artificial light. I just let ambient room light and maybe natural sunlight from your home, sun the fish. I don't use any artificial light like LED or fluorescent over my quarantine tank because I think it's been beneficial for me anyway to just let the fish rest and not have, you know, a lot of light over it to where it's kind of, you know, on high alert because it's being, you know, beamed with light. So at least the first week, I would suggest not having any LED or artificial light over your quarantine tank. And then if you have an adjustable light, just having it on a really low setting from then on even is going to aid you in a successful quarantine. So next I will go on to medications that can be used in quarantine. I haven't used any of these on Pebbles, actually. I tend to do a lot less these days than I used to. I used to just immediately throw medication at these fish. I don't really think that's the way to go anymore. I think doing your regular large water changes lowers the bacterial count in the water, and it leaves less room for the fish coming down with something like a bacterial infection or falling victim to, sometimes the fish, they have a rough time in shipping and they end up getting some fin rot or fin tearing from shipping. But you don't necessarily need to salt or medicate the tank. You just need to start by doing, you know, what you will already be doing, which are the large water changes, and that pulls out a majority of the bacteria that could be opportunistic on something like fin rot and damage from shipping. And the fish can ultimately heal itself, being in a non-stressful quarantining environment. And you might not need to use the medication if you just give the fish a chance to rest and heal itself. So something that you can feed though, if you, this is all at least after a week or two of just rest for the fish, but you can feed Hex Shield by New Life Spectrum. It's an anti-parasitic, internal parasitic medication that I wouldn't say is going to harm your fish by feeding it to them. So it's one of those things where it's no harm done. If there were no parasites, no harm done. If there were parasites, then you've taken care of it. I have not fed this to Pebbles only because something to look for if you're really thinking that the fish might have internal parasites would be if the fish is pooping, if the poop is white, or it's just like the casing of a poop and there's actually no like digested matter in it and it's just empty. But let me be clear, when you have just received a goldfish in the mail, if you have received it from shipping, the shipper would have most likely fasted your goldfish for a few days prior to its trip. So it may very well initially have those empty, you know, poops, like the white poop. So that is not something to be alarmed about. They just don't have anything in their system. But once you start feeding them, it should be the color of the food you're feeding. So if it's not, then that is when you could use something like the Hex Shield. So it's usually pretty apparent if a fish is riddled with internal parasites, in my experience, which again, it's only a year long. You'll know if your fish has internal parasites. At least you'll be, you know, skeptical of it. I'm not skeptical of it because this fish, it goes to the bathroom normal, and I can see that what I fed it has digested and the waste has come out the other end. It's not empty, it's not white, it's not clear, it's not stringy, it's normal. So I'm not going to feed this to Pebbles. But that's up to you. Like I said, it's a little risk in feeding it. If there's no internal parasites, it's probably not going to harm the fish either way. So maybe for you, better safe than sorry, and this is a good bet. Something else that a lot of people do in quarantine is Prozzy Pro. Kind of like I mentioned earlier, I feel like Flukes parasites, although this treats for more than just Flukes parasites, Flukes is, and other parasites are present in most healthy bodies of water, and the fish is not susceptible to them doing harm if everything else is going smooth in the aquarium or pond. So I'm not going to treat Pebbles with this, but in the past, if I've been suspicious, like there's heavy gilling or flashing and darting around the tank, hitting itself on objects, we might have a situation where Prozzy Pro is beneficial because possibly from the stress of shipping and handling, the the fluke's parasite or parasite has had a chance to multiply and take hold of the fish, and the Prosy Pro will knock down those numbers significantly along with your 100% water changes. So again, Prosy, super safe, even if you don't have anything parasitically present. It's a safe bet, you know, so you can definitely use it without worry of maybe misdiagnosing and treating something that wasn't ever there. This is safe no matter what. Salt is something that can be used as a gentle, generally it will help the fish breathe easier, it will de-stress the fish, and it will encourage the fish to make more slime coat to heal like something like fin rot or maybe scrapes or lesions from shipping and handling, something like that. So salt is something that is rather gentle and you can use in quarantine. And then lastly, I've only one time had a fish get ick in quarantine from stress. Possibly they brought it from the local fish store that I got it from, but it can kind of pop out of nowhere, whether it's transferred from an LFS or it was never present. It can just occur in a healthy system if there is stress. So Riddick is my number one go-to for treating ick. It has worked for me every time, and I have had no deaths from ick in my experience. So this isn't something that I would treat as a preventative. I would really have to see that there was ick spots present on my goldfish to treat it. And this is the treatment. So Riddick, if you have something like ick that makes itself known during the time that your goldfish is in quarantine. So I'm going to end this video with a demo on how I water change this tote for pebbles. Something you can do if your fish is, you know, during the water changes, what you can do, just something that would enrich the fish, is I take Pebbles out to my backyard and let him rest in some natural sunlight while I'm doing the water change. So with Pebbles outside resting in the sun, I just then take the sponge filter out of the quarantine tank and I dump the whole tote on my side yard. So I realize I have the luxury of doing that because my side yard is just right here. If you have a tank, you would just use the gravel siphon and pull out, you know, 92 or 100% of that water and do the water change like that. So I'll go ahead and show you what I do. Before this gets full, is I use this hose filter. It's a carbon pre-filter, inline filter for the hose, and it filters out chlorine and heavy metals and phosphates and lots of things like that from your tap water. So it's a way of filtering your tap water. And if you don't have the room to, you know, age your tap water before use, this is a really, really, really great solution. So I super recommend this, and I talk about it in some of my other videos. I order replacements every few months based on how much water I use, because about 10,000 gallons of water can be filtered before the carbon is no longer active. So I will put the link to this on Amazon in the description below. Things that I wanted to add before I bring this video to an end is to get your quarantine tank up and running 24 to 72 hours prior to bringing your new goldfish either home from the fish store. If you can, if you know you're going to get a goldfish from your local fish store, prepare the tank ahead of time. Of course, if you're having one shipped, you know ahead of time, so you will have you know, plentiful notice to get that quarantine tank filled and begin aerating with whatever kind of filtration you're using, optimally 72 hours prior to when the goldfish comes. So that's one thing. And then the other thing is what to feed your goldfish. I have a video that I will also, maybe I can learn to have that drop down in this part right here, but if I don't, if you look in my previous videos, I've just recently made one on what I feed my goldfish. So there's a lot of options beyond the standard flakes and pellets diet that a lot of people use for their goldfish. So I have a lot of good ideas in there, and some more information as well. So I'll refer you to that video, and I don't need to go on in this one as well on that. And then lastly would be that if you are ordering goldfish from multiple places, like maybe you've gotten one from, well, for me as an example, I have pebbles that I've just shown you in this 18 gallon tote from Goldfish Island. And then also my husband and I went to San Jose a couple weeks ago for Father's Day, and we got a demikin from Janky Koi, goldfish and koi. And I would never ever recommend putting goldfish from different sources in one quarantine tank together. So I have that second goldfish that we got from out of town in another separate quarantine tank with a brand new filter, and that fish is in fish cycling his own tank as well as pebbles in his. So definitely not mixing that, like I spoke about the bacteria and the microbes. You don't want to mix goldfish from different sources in one quarantine tank, even though they're both separate, or it's separate from your main goldfish tank. They're a risk and a danger to one another. So goldfish from different sources, no matter if you get them on the same day, quarantine them separate. If you can't, then don't get them. Just get one and see it through, and then go on to the other place that you wish to purchase goldfish from. That's some strong advice. So just so that you have the best chance of not having a bad experience from mixing goldfish from different sources. It's just another way that you can eliminate stress and eliminate risk. So anyway, so I will end this with, this is my telepong spawn. They are so big now. I don't know if you can see them when they've swam by. They are 11 weeks old today. So I'm super happy about that. I will go ahead and give you a little bit of footage of them up close, even though it has nothing to do with this video. But these are my pearl scale demikin keepers that I have chosen to grow out. Hopefully I can grow them out another, you know, 6 to 8 months before I decide if I am selling them. So anyway, I will give you an up close of them. They make me super happy. They're here in my 65 gallon right now. And thanks again for watching my channel, and I hope that this video has been useful.